How's it going, everybody? Poser Mobile here, bringing you another absolute banger of a platinum. Today, we've got another one from Chorus Worldwide called Last Time I Saw You. Shout out to them for getting me a code for the game. And you're looking at $17 on the PlayStation Store with only one worldwide stack, and that's PS5 exclusive. Do be aware that the trophy and achievement lists are identical, so anything that works for this trophy guide should work just fine with you achievement hunters out there as well. If you've ever played any of the other games Chorus has put out there, you know that this is going to be a story-heavy game, and it definitely is. Honestly, I would recommend that you just go and buy the game and play it one time all the way through, going through all the dialogue from all the characters, and just experience that way first. It takes about twice as long as this trophy guide, somewhere around 6 to 8 hours, but it really does have an awesome storyline with a bunch of characters that you can get invested in. It's hard to explain much of the story without getting into spoiler territory right off the bat, but you're a kid in 1980s Japan having recurring dreams about a girl in some kind of forest. Literally everything beyond that feels like it's a spoiler, so I'll leave it at that for those of you who want to get the game and play through it yourself. Seriously, I can't recommend this enough. Trophy-wise, there's a number of trophies to look out for, but the vast majority of them aren't missable as long as you make a save at the point of no return on day 9. They make it very clear when it's taking place, making sure you're aware that you can't go back from what you're doing. This ends up being the best time to go through and collect everything, finish all the side quests, and take care of the miscellaneous trophies. The only thing that seems to be missable is one of the characters, maybe two. I couldn't find Maki, one of the girls you can meet in town, on the point of no return day, and the Odin vendor is uninteractable for whatever reason on that day. You can interact with both of them on day 1, so I'd recommend just interacting with everybody at least once the first time you see them, just to make sure you're safe with that. I do need to make this clear though, if you do happen to miss one of them and get all the way to day 9, you're unfortunately out of luck and have to restart the entire game to unlock them again, which brings me to my major point for this game. Make a save every day. Seriously, you get 9 save slots to choose from, you've got a save point right in your room when you wake up every morning, so just make a separate save every day to make sure you don't miss anything. As far as the trophy guide goes, I don't think it really requires a full commentary walkthrough or anything. It's all pretty simple and straightforward. I've got timestamps for each day, so maybe check out whichever day that I'm on if you're playing along, just to make sure you didn't miss anything. The hardest trophy by far is Ninja Hero Retro Gaming, which needs you to beat the NES-type game that you have at home, and it's rough. You essentially have to play flawlessly through the first 4 levels of an action platformer just so you can get to the 5th level and beat the game. This is also required for the Art Collector Trophy, which requires you to unlock and then view every piece of art in the gallery in the main menu screen. You unlock a piece of art when you finish that NES game, so it's up to you whether you want to get it out of the way as soon as possible on day 3 or wait until day 9 and fight your way through it then. Oh, one extra note, there's a vendor you'll meet in the forest that sells some very expensive collectibles that you'll need, but once you finish the set of side quests you get from her, she opens up her shop to you free of charge. So don't worry about buying the stuff from her until you get through those, probably around the point of no return on day 9. Aside from that, you're going to have to find the 4 hidden hot springs and interact with them. You have to interact with every single shrine save point throughout the game at least once, try coffee at the cafe, pet the dog at least once, and hit 10 baseballs in a row, though that last one seemed to pop for me just by hitting 10 baseballs total, not in a row. Everything else should unlock along the way while you're finishing every side quest in the game and collecting every last collectible. There's one trophy which I'm not sure is missable or not, as I got it on my first playthrough without giving it any thought. If they get a scene to pop at the very end of the game, like think post-credits scene, between the fox spirit and cat spirit. Didn't go out of my way to do anything special to unlock this, but I guess just make sure you talk to them every chance you get to make sure it pops at the end. It's not a huge game. Like I said earlier, if you do absolutely everything and actually read all the dialogue in the game, you'll end up taking maybe 6 to 8 hours total. But if you're just going for the trophies as fast as possible, it should take you somewhere in the 3 to 4 hour range. I think without the NES game trophy, this is maybe a 2 out of 10 at most. The NES game trophy by itself is probably a 5 or 6 out of 10. So be prepared to take a few tries to get that handled. All right, that'll do it for me though, everybody. Go ahead and leave a like if you enjoy the video. Comment down below which number platinum this was for you. And subscribe to the channel for more trophy hunting content. This is number 1043 for me.
Thank you. 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 Thank you.